Hello, hello. Today I have Every Second Turn Loop by Elcilia, I think is how you say that. I've never done, not just for a recording, I've just never, I don't think I've ever done one of their puzzles as far as I can tell. But this puzzle was recommended quite highly by Viking Prime, so, or not this puzzle in particular, actually, this series of puzzles. And I kind of picked one that looked a little easier because made me a little nervous. So this is a 2-star, hopefully it'll go pretty quickly. And we can do some harder ones later on. But what are the rules here? So we have normal Sudoku rules apply, which means I have the digits 1 to 9 in every row, every column, and every mark 3x3 box, once each, no repeats. I've got a parity loop, which says draw a single 1-cell-wide loop of orthogonally connected cells under the grid that enters no cell more than once. So I have my pen tool out, so I'll be drawing a loop. It can't go diagonally like that. It can only go orthogonally, and once it closes, that's it. It can't cross itself or anything silly like that. It's just a single loop. And then we have adjacent digits along the loop. So suppose the loop looked like this. Then adjacent digits on the loop have opposite parity. So if this were odd, this would be even, odd, even, odd, even, odd, even, etc. So that's the loop. Circles. Every circle must be visited by the loop, and the loop must turn at every circle. Okay. The loop must turn, furthermore, between 2 circles, the loop must turn exactly once more. Digits in circles equal the sum of steps until the loop reaches it the next turn in each direction. Okay, so I was confused by this when I was looking at the puzzle earlier and I looked up the example. So let's say, for example, the loop went like this, right? So this probably breaks all sorts of things, but suppose this were the loop, or at least part of the loop. Then what would have to be true is that this cell, I would know the digit, this circle, I would know the digit in the circle because I can count the number of steps until the turn in both directions. So if I go this direction, there's 1 step until a turn. And if I go this direction, there are 2 steps until a turn for a total of 3. So this would have to be a 3. That's how I'm interpreting this rule in my looking at the example. Makes me think that that is in fact right. And then Kropke dots. So we've got white Kropke dots. So digits on either side of a Kropke have to be adjacent. Consecutive. They're adjacent across the Kropke. The digits are consecutive. So those are the rules. And despite this being a 2-star puzzle, I actually don't know. I'm not sure how quite to break into this. I assume it has to do with the circles, but I don't know how to even start. I suppose it's up here where I have 3 circles, but there are lots of ways that this could. Well, one thing to note is that I can't do something like this because then these would both be 2, right? Which is not allowed. But it seems like there are lots of ways this could work. Can I do this? Sure. Maybe. No. The loop has to turn at circles. Okay, so it's the edges. Because the loop has to turn at circles, I can't go straight through a circle at an edge, and so I can't go up from here or left from here. So they have to go toward the center at the edge. That is going to be big, I think, for this. How does this... I'm guessing we're going to have to do this, but I don't know how to prove that. So I guess there are only 1, 2, yeah, there are only 4 ways this can go, so we can kind of check them all. So I think this works fairly obviously, and this doesn't work also, I think, fairly obviously. So the reason this doesn't work is from column 2, I can't turn right because that will close the loop and I won't be able to visit all the circles. So I'd have to turn left, but then I have to turn twice before reaching a circle. And there is a rule that says you can only turn once between circles. So that's not going to work. Exact same logic, that's not going to work. So the question is, do we have this or do we have this? No, we don't have this. So the reason this doesn't work is if I go, suppose you extend this out, then I know this value in the cell, it's 2, right? Because I go 1 before turning here, 1 before turning here, that's a 2. And now the problem is these cells. I can't have both of them extend, because if both of them extend, I'm going to change this to center only. If I have both of these extend, then the loop closes on itself, it doesn't work. So I can have one of them extend, but then the other is going to have to not extend, and then this will also become a 2, breaking Sudoku rules. So we don't have that way either. So the only way that this works here is like this, oops, like that. And now this can't turn up because I will end up back in myself. So we have to go down here, same here. And this is in fact a 2, which means these are not 2, which means these must extend. And then I can, so what I'm seeing, and I'm just kind of noticing now, is because of the one bend rule, basically what's going to happen is the circle, from the circle, the loop's going to go some distance, it's going to turn, and then continue on until it hits another circle. So the question is, like, where, how far along can this go? It could turn here, it could turn here. I think I can't turn here, because if I do, I'll cut this loop off, or I'll cut this off. Basically, I'll have an odd number of dangling loops over here, and over here, it's not gonna work. So that one doesn't work, but this probably works, and this works. So there's actually a lot of choices here. This could be, let's see, this would be 2 if it turned here, 3 if it turned here. So 3 is possible, 4 is possible, 5 is not, 6 is possible, 7 is possible. And then down here we have 3 is possible if we turn here, and 4 is possible if we turn here. This doesn't work because there's no turn. So this is 3 or 4. And then this is a parity loop. So, right, so this is even color, even blue, an odd orange. And we have to alternate parity. So this has to be 4 and this has to be 6. So I actually know exactly where it turns. Hold on. Gotta change to widgets. So this will turn after 3, because I've got 1 here, and we'll go to the circle. This will turn after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and go to the circle. But now I think I can go left. I think I could do something like this. I think that's fine. So, okay, so let's fill these in. Well, I know there's an 8 here, because that's the other even digit. So I know these are odd. I can do more odd even stuff here. Odd in the circle will probably help. Even on that circle will probably help. This has to go down. This can't go down, so it's gotta go at least to here. I think this could do, I think this circle has to take one of those two strands, but I think either one is possible. Actually, is this possible? Yeah, and then we go over here and back like this. That's okay. All right. But actually, I can color these, even though I haven't connected them to the loop, I can color them by checkerboard logic. So anywhere that's on the loop is going to have odd even parity consistent with the original loop, according to a checkerboard. What do I mean by that? I mean, if you think about the loop, there's only one loop. So anything that's part of the loop is part of this one single loop. I guess I can draw this too. Which means that, anytime I move along the loop, I'm either changing the row by one or changing the column by one. So I'm going from one set of checkerboard squares to the other. And every time I move in the loop, because I can't move diagonally, I'm always moving from one to the other, which means that if there is a loop in a particular square, I know its parity by where it is on the checkerboard. So as an example, suppose that weren't true, right? Suppose I had this cell as both loop and orange. What that would mean is somehow I have to get here, moving only up, down, left, and right, in such a way that I changed kind of the parity of, like, I changed which part of the, which color on the checkerboard I'm on, and didn't change my color, or vice versa. I changed color without changing which side of the checkerboard I'm on, which just can't happen. So it just doesn't work. Which means that this is orange. This is orange by, well, I guess first I should say these are even. And this will be orange by what's left in the box. This will be even, as will this. These will be odd. This is one of each, so I've got four even, so that's odd. That's my even eight. Oops, eight. This will be odd, because that's all that's left in the row, connected to an even. And this is now basically at an edge. So I know the loop does this, and I know the parity of these two things. I don't know which way it goes, I don't think, yet. Because this probably can't go right, right? Because if I go to the right, I'm going to have to go down to this. And then I have the problem of loose danglers over here. Like, how do I possibly... Oh, no, that does work. Actually, that works great. Not sure what I was thinking. Right, it was this one that couldn't go down, which is a very different thing. But now I have four evens in this row, so let's do the easy stuff. Those have to be odd. Those have to be even by the box. Here I've got one each, which is less helpful. Interestingly, this, whichever way I go, is going to have to turn immediately. Does this work? This probably works, right? Yeah, that works. Okay. Well, this has to turn. This can't go down, or it can't go down because it completes a loop. It can't go up because that's the wrong parity. So this goes over, which means this is even. And we're running out of evens in that column, but we're not there that this has to go as well. And this can't go down, it's completes the loop, can't go up because it's the wrong parity, so this goes over here. So now this, oh no, this can still do that. But we do know this is orange. This has to turn, but I don't know that I can say which way that turns yet. That's orange. Oh, I should know this, right? This is orange, this is blue, this is blue, and this is orange. This is odd by the column, so this has to turn, and it's going to continue on until it hits a circle. This has to continue on. So this is orange, this is orange, this is blue. By crappy dot, that has to be orange, and by what's left in everything, that has to be even. This is one of each. This is a turn, so we're going to go down, and I can't go back left, so this is going to go right, making this odd and this even. This is going to, and once, because it turns, it's going to go until it hits a circle. So that does this. Somehow missed coloring this blue and that blue. And that's orange. Here I've got two of each. I don't necessarily know how they go. I can't even say these are different, or these are different, or anything like that. Well, this is one of each, and I have three other odds. So I've got one more odd and two evens in here, which is a little bit tight, but here I've got three of each. So those are two odds and an even, but again, not much help. These are one of each, so these are one of each. I should fill in digits that I know, right? So this is one. Oh no, I don't know this because I don't know when this turns. One, two, three. Yeah, that could turn there. This can't turn up here though. Ah, I see. So this one. What is this? It's odd. It can't be one. So it's got to be at least three. It can't be nine, right? Because if I do nine, that's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. There's just not enough space, so it can't be nine. It can't be five, because if it's five, that means I go, because so where I have set up now is three. One this way, two that way. that's three. If I go five, if I go to five, that's two more. Down doesn't get me to a circle, up does, but then what happens here? This is gonna have to go up and over and it'll complete its own loop. So five doesn't work. And seven gets us supposedly to here and then a turn, but I can't turn from there. So that doesn't work either. So this is in fact a three. And this now turns down. Oh no, wrong one. This one turns down because of this three. This one is at least one, two, three. It's gotta go at least one this way. So this is five, seven, or nine. It probably does this, right? One, two, three, four, five. Yeah, it's probably a five, but we don't know that for sure yet. I've only got one more even in all of these. And a lot of evens here. Okay, not sure that works. Could this possibly be nine? We wouldn't go up then. We have to go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. No, not enough space. That's not nine. Five goes to here. One, two, three, four. No, it's not gonna get me to a circle. So this is in fact a five. I like how we're getting that the numbers in the circle. So I thought originally we'd be doing all this pathing and then we'd be able to fill in the numbers from the pathing. But I like how it goes the other direction where, because we know the parity, it kind of limits, we know the parity of the circle where it ends up, that limits the possible places it can go and kind of fills in where everything has to be, which is pretty neat. All right, now this one has to continue on because that one reached a loop. Has to continue on again because that loop's taken. I wonder if it has to go here actually. So what's this? One, two, three, four, five, six. It can't, oh yeah, six is good. The other option is eight, but if I go to eight, I can't go down to a circle and I can't go up to a circle. So it is in fact a six. We're gonna go to here. I can put in some looping. These are all orange, that's orange, and that's orange, and that's blue. That's by either rows or boxes. I should know this, right? One, two, one, two, three, four, five, six. So that's a six. This one. If I go left and down, that's going to complete the loop and eliminate that. So we've got to do this and that. That's the only way it works. I can finish the coloring on the loop. That's going to be orange. One of each is right. Yep. This I should know. One, two, three, four. That's going to be odd. And that's going to be even. One of each. Oh, these are both odd. So that's blue and that's orange. One of each. So it's either, it's one of these crisscrosses, which means there's no way I can figure it out from rows and columns and boxes. I have to wait until I get some digits to figure that out. I should know these. So it's one, two, three, four. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, three. I think that's it. Okay, so let's see. Let's start with evens. There's fewer of them, should be easier. These are six and eight, so that's eight and that's six by column Sudoku. These are four and six, which I know from rows. Six is here. I guess I don't know those yet, but that 2-8 pair makes that a four. Six can't go here or here, so it has to go here. I don't know those yet. Two, four, six, eight. Two, four, I still don't know. This will be two or four as well, but I get 2-8 four pair. And this eight, this two, this eight. This is a 2-6 in the row, a 2-6 pair. I get six here. I actually saw this one first, but same thing. That's a six. This is 4, 8. This is 2. That's 4. I have a 2/8 deadly pattern, but those will be resolved by crop keys. I have a 7/9 pair here. Hold on, I can probably figure out something. That's a 4, that's a 2, that's a 4. Six, I need a 6 in here. 6 will go here, and then 2 will go here. So these are my blues, these are my oranges. This is unresolved. So we have to do the oranges. So let's see, this is a 1, because it can't be a 3. I'm just trying to get all the crop keys first. Those are marked. This one. It just can't be a 5 for now. Okay, so we'll get that later, I hope. Let's see. 3 has to be here. Start with 3s, because there's a bunch of them in the grid already. 3 is here, and here, and here, actually. Puts it here. Make that a 2. All right, so we've got our blues done. This is now not 1 or 3 anymore. We have a 7/9 pair, making these 1 and 5. 5 here sees that. That makes that a 7. Makes this a 9. This is not a 3. 1, 5, 9. Not a 5. Not quite. This is also 1 or 9. I'm not done with 3. So what 3s am I missing? 3. I have an X-wing on 3s, but I think that's all I'm missing. I have 7, right? Yeah, 7, and an X-wing on 3s. I have some 5s, I think. Oh, not many, actually. Ooh, but I do get 5 is down here, so 5 is here. This is a 7/9 pair. So this is actually a 1/5 pair. Making this a 7/9 pair. Actually, we have a 7/9 pair already. And we don't have that yet. So we have 3, we need a 1/5 and a 7 or 9, meaning this is 1 or 5. We have actually easier. 1 looks in here, so that's a 1. We miss a 5, that's a 1. 5 now goes here, that's a 7/9. This is a 9 down here sees this. This is a 5. No, this is a 1. 5/7 is resolved by this 7. This one sees 9 and 1. These are from 5 and 7, which I don't think are resolved. This is a 9, meaning this is from 1 and 3, and that is resolved. 3 now goes here. That's a 9. That's a 7. These are from 1, 7, 9. We have 7, 9 on the sides, 1 here. 1 looks at that 5. This is a 7, 9 pair. 7, oh, that's a 7, that's a 9, that's a 7, that's a 5. We've got to be done now. 1, 5, 7. Right? I think I just didn't. Yeah, great. So thanks so much for that puzzle. Thanks, Viking Prime, for suggesting this series. I liked it a lot. It's kind of simple once you figured out this first break in the box. But it was good fun, and I'll try. Something a little more challenging next time I break into this series. And I suggest everyone check out a puzzle of your difficulty in this series. All right, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.